Welcome back. I am so excited for this segment. Have you written a book? Have you thought about writing a book? Have you dreamed about writing a book, or do you know someone who wrote a book?
Lauren has written a book. Lauren's book is amazing.
You totally stole my thunder.
Yes, I have written a book. And I wrote it with a very special purpose in mind, meaning at the time I had a platform, I had a message, I was on a mission, and I needed to get the message out. But I know that there are people who have written books, made millions of dollars, created products, done so much more than what I did with my book, and we've got the expert in the house. Nina Hershberger is here to share
all the way from Indiana.
Oh my goodness, to share what can we do with a book. I know our viewers have books that they've written, that they've wanted to write, and really just talking about the options besides it showing up on a bookshelf in a bookstore.
Yeah.
So
well,
what do we
as
do?
As you know, Lauren, most of the books don't show up in
they
a bookstore.
They don't indeed.
Yeah. And you've made your book just a business card, actually.
I have, in fact. I was in bookstores initially, so the original version came out in 2002.
Yeah.
And I was in all the bookstores around New York City. Mm-hmm. I was spattered in Barnes & Noble across the country. I did a whole book tour. I did all the stuff that you're supposed to do. And then I said, you know what? The most fun thing about my book is giving it away.
I know.
And I would like more people to read it.
Yes.
And I have walked, no joke, I have walked into strangers' bathrooms
and
found my book sitting there. Like, I'm invited to a cocktail party and I go to use the restroom and my book is sitting there in their stack or in their little holder. And I love that because that's when people have time to read.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
So it was designed to be read in 45 minutes and then you could go back and do more with it. I mean, it had so much intent behind it. But the most important thing is that somebody has to it.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
well, the most important thing is first you got to get it out of yourself.
Well, there you go.
Which I know you've had an expert on there talking about how to write your book.
Yes,
but now that we've gotten it written.
Exactly. What do we do with it?
What do you do with it? Yeah. It's interesting you tell that story. I was in an Airbnb down in Florida a few months ago. And wouldn't you know, there was a book, and it happened to be a friend of mine who lives, I don't know, Las Vegas or something, totally away.
Yeah.
And there was his book in the Airbnb.
And doesn't that make you feel
it
good?
It does. You never know where it's going to show up.
Yeah, somehow we have that pride of ownership, even for people who we know.
Yeah.
It's not our book.
Yeah.
It's their book, but we get so excited knowing it's being read.
That's exactly right. And there's all kinds of books. One of the books that I talk about is legacy books. You got a story in, you want to share it. You had an expertise.
Yes.
Something you want to share.
So I had an authority book.
You had authority book. There's all kinds of books. Here's a book. This one is actually from a dentist who, you know, was a smile makeover person. I mean, he would do as much as $132,000 smile makeovers. That's a testimonial book.
Yep.
It's only a book of 49 stories of people that he'd fix their smile.
Wow.
This is a really good idea.
That's a cool idea,
That's a
right?
really good idea.
I know.
And it's an easy one to produce for a client, you know, if you had a client who did that. Because we just said, give me the stories.
Yeah.
And so we just put them. In fact, in this particular book, I even made different fonts because it was like different people talking.
So were the stories told by the patients, or
patients,
did he tell the stories?
Oh, no,
they told their own stories.
No, we asked the patients to do that.
That's great.
Here's another book, and this is a gal who had gastric sleeve surgery and lost 179 pounds.
Well, that's a story to tell.
That's
her story.
Really cool story.
It's her story. But how do you use that book? So, I mean, we got it published. How do you use that book? Well, she was so successful that the doctor that she worked with said, will you come work for me?
Oh,
and so now this actually is a book that people get, they read her story, and then they book surgery with that.
And they meet her.
And they meet her, and they book surgery with that surgeon.
Super.
That's very
so
cool.
That's neat.
What else you got?
This book is really, really cool. So this particular gentleman.
I love the title.
Me too.
So don't retire, reinvent, because that's for our age.
Mm-hmm.
And he was a financial planner, and he worked with very, very successful people. And what would happen is they would get, they would get to a certain age, and they knew they should retire or something, sell their business, whatever. Okay. But they said, what will we do? What will we do? We're going to retire, but what will we do? And so he has a process where he helps them figure out that meaningful future.
Nice.
And so it's a real thing. And so, you know, I mean, this is actually a book that, that he gives to people, and they figure that out as well. This one. Now, this is, we talk about products. So here is, this was another financial planner.
Wow.
Okay.
The financial planning world, you really can't talk about financial planning because then you got to go to compliance. Mm-hmm. And, you know, there's all sorts of rules and stuff. But this guy, what he noticed was, they didn't have everything organized. They didn't know if they had a will, where was the will? Mm-hmm. Who was it if I died?
That's such a good question.
You know, accident stuff, all of that. So organizing. And in fact, we created a workbook for him.
Oh, makes so much sense.
That's such a good idea.
Yeah. Wow.
Oh, wow. And then I liked how it was a large print edition.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
For those of us over 40,
that's
right?
That's right. That's right. So he's creating a six-week course. Now, it's interesting about this book, because most of the books that we do, we put up on Amazon. Mm-hmm. So I'm sure your book is up on Amazon.
Yes.
And we did not do this with this book. So this is another concept, another idea that you can do. We're actually looking for a sponsor. We're looking for somebody who really wants to take that, will put their name on it, and then he will get royalties.
Oh.
So he wrote the book, but it doesn't need to have his name on it. He wants to have somebody.
A ghostwriting part, like a
ghostwriter. He almost would be the ghostwriter.
He would be the ghostwriter. That's a good way to say it.
Amazing.
Yeah. But yeah, somebody who doesn't want to, but has a whole group of people who need this kind of thing.
Huh. That's a great idea. What else you got? Cool.
So here's a book. This is one of, this was my very first book, my personal very first book that
this
I wrote.
Nina's book. Yeah. Nina's, I'm sorry, Nina.
That's okay. And so 101 ways to wow your clients, customers, and patients. You know, even if you're retired, even if you don't have a business anymore, you got a lot of knowledge. And that knowledge is really good to pass on to the younger generation.
Yeah, this is really
this is the
cool.
kind of stuff that gets lost when it's not shared.
Exactly.
Yes.
Now,
some of these are really interesting, like raise your prices.
That's right.
Wow, I need this book. Make money while you sleep. You guys need to buy this book for
Nina. And that one is on Amazon. Now open it up to just a page. I want to show one. So each one is very simple little ideas. So you don't have to read that book cover to cover. All you have to do is go one page and you're going to pull out an idea.
Yeah, I really love that too, because it's like, you know, you can just flip through it if you have 5 extra seconds and like something.
And you learn something.
And you learn something even if it's like just one page and they're self-contained.
I really love that.
And think how many people have so much information in this community that they really could share.
Absolutely.
I really love that.
Generation.
Love this.
This was my this is not quite the latest book, but again, I'm a marketer and I'm a publisher.
Wow. You do a lot in 30 minutes.
In 30 minutes.
Yes. How to find 10,000 in any business in 30 minutes.
That is
incredible.
Because it's just laying right there.
Yeah.
Have you ever, diamonds? What was the diamond thing? I forgot. Diamonds, all those, acres of diamonds.
Oh.
That's what it was, a book. And, you know, we've got so many opportunities if you're into the money making, but even so, if it, just sitting around, fun things you can do. And so this book is just
very cool. You know what I love about what you do too is you make it so accessible. People have a second, if they have a minute, if they have an hour, you can read it from cover to cover, or you can just grab a piece. It's amazing, and you've got all kinds of visuals in here. I can tell you're the master.
And well, what I have learned to do, now you wouldn't do this in a, you know, the big publishing houses, but what I've learned to do is make big fonts and little fonts and different fonts because it's easier to read.
It is. It keeps it engaging too.
Yes. And what's this, the 90-day author?
Okay, so now you want to be an author.
Okay.
How well can you be an author in 90 days? Well, you can hire a ghostwriter.
Uh-huh.
You can hire an author's coach to help you through it. Maybe you're going to, I license a lot of my content.
Mm.
So in other words, we've written it and I sell it over and over and over.
Wow.
And so within 90 days, you could have your own. In fact, here's one of those licensed books, dental implants.
Wow.
What every person ought to know about dental implants. How did they start? What happens if you don't have them? You know, what does it look like? All of those kind of things. That's what I call a long-form sales letter book.
Right.
Yes, that makes sense.
A few years
sense.
Ago, my mother, who's going to be 92 this year, needed dental implants. And I was just writing that book at that time. And she went to her dentist and she said, well, who should I go to? And he said, I don't know. I don't do them. Here's two names. I have no idea if they're any good. And if she'd had that, if he'd had that book, right. he could have said, well, this guy wrote this book, mm-hmm. you know,
right.
chuck it
out.
Here
the expert
it is.
Authority.
If you need it.
That's right.
Yep. Expert
which is
authority.
Your book, really.
That's
right.
exactly yes. my book, yeah.
Your book.
What else
do
you have over there?
Am
this
I
is
going
really
to,
interesting.
Am I going too fast?
No,
no, no,
we don't want to miss a thing. We don't want to miss a thing.
This guy.
Another thing I love, just real quick, I love how you make it super digestible with like 30 minutes, mm-hmm. 90 days. Mm-hmm. You know, it's really great marketing.
Yeah. So this particular guy, this is co-authored by Jim Connolly, a great friend of mine and myself. Jim's story, he's in his 80s, but his story was, he was it took him 5 years to get through high school. Mm. He was a fighter. He grew up in the Pittsburgh area. Mm-hmm. And he ended up leaving just after he was in the service for a few years. And he was getting in fights and everything. He said, Judge, he was taken to the judge. He got, you know, arrested. He said, I'm leaving for California tomorrow. Mm-hmm. He left for California, came clear over here, paid $100 for his cousin to drive him here. And within 6 years, he was general manager of the Beverly Wilshire Hotel.
What? Which yes. was like a huge huge success by any standard.
Yeah. Yeah.
How did he do it?
It's in that book.
Read this book.
It's in that book.
This is amazing. Okay, so we're going to put all of these on the website, our website,
yep.
so our viewers right. can...
Can actually find
can
them.
Find
yeah.
them. We'll put them up on Amazon, and so they can click on the link and just go to.
Okay,
them.
I'm not sure we even got that one on Amazon yet.
Okay,
but you'll
so
have
this
my contact.
This is fairly yep. new.
Fairly yep. new.
All right,
that's right.
You'll tell
really
us.
Really cool.
Yep. And
yep.
what else do we have over there?
All right, an orthodontist.
This
actually, he's
cool.
not. He's a marketer who markets to orthodontists.
Wow.
And he said, because everybody usually that goes into the medical field or many, many fields, they know mm-hmm. how to do surgery. They know how to do mm-hmm. ortho. They don't know how to market.
Sure.
They don't know how to get business.
Booking right. yourself solid.
And so this secrets. Marketer guy teaches 16 secrets on how to keep an orthodontist book solid and uh-huh. to have a life of how they want to do it.
Okay. So if you or your... children
that's
are
right.
orthodontists. This is one for you,
that's
for sure.
Right.
Really interesting stuff.
And this guy's made $12 million from that book.
From this book?
From that book.
What?
From that book.
$12 million?
How to not get your ass kicked in the insurance business.
Because he taught other insurance agents to how to do what he did. He took a 30-year-old, his father's insurance agent, and tripled it in 3 years.
Wow.
And so we've shared some of the secrets in
that. Oh,
that's
my goodness.
So okay, cool.
I just have to read a really quick testimonial. Michael took me from overworked, exhausted, nearly broke, and ready to quit the insurance business to fit, happy, wealthy, and Erie Insurance's top producing agent the past 3 years in a row. While working a manageable 35-hour work week, coaching my kids' sports team, and taking 4 to 5 family vacations per year.
Wow.
That's such an amazing, like, that's so awesome
that
what you can do
amazing.
With the book. The benefit you can help other people.
And the beauty about it, I'm sure there's people in this community who have that kind of knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't have to be a legacy
mm-hmm.
book.
Sure.
It doesn't have to be a story, but it could be literally information that they're sharing, mm-hmm. again, with to help the younger people be more successful. In real estate.
Oh, and certainly Orange County.
Sell your home, what to avoid. One thing I've noticed that you do that's really cool is the using the negative strategically.
Oh, okay.
I think that's really smart that you do that.
Well, the story with this guy is we had just finished that book. He was, mm-hmm. You know, if you're going to sell your house, usually you interview a couple people,
mm-hmm.
two or three, whatever, how many real estate agents.
Mm-hmm.
And so he was just going to a showing or an open or going to their house. And they said, why should we pick you? And he pulls that out and he said, well, I just wrote the book. There was no questions.
Yeah.
They signed
absolutely.
Right then.
Of
that was
course.
It. So even if they don't read the book,
yep.
it
you've
was
written
the
a
power
book.
Of being an author. And you know that word.
It absolutely makes
absolutely.
A difference. It really
absolutely.
Does.
Absolutely.
Yep.
It's amazing.
If you're the only one in the green room with a book, you win.
You win.
Yeah. Nina, this is amazing.
Amazing.
And we'd like to have you back to talk about more. How can people find you?
Well, they can go to my email is probably the best way to get a hold of me. It's Nina, N-I-N-A, at megabucksmarketing.com. Com.
Great name.
That is a great name.
It's all in the name. Yeah. We'll put that up on the screen.
Right.
And will you come back and share some more? Thank you.
I'll even tell you next time about my latest book.
Wait, tell us now. Ooh, generating leads. And positioning yourself as the expert with your own book.
So now here's the story. When I come back, I'm just finishing a book for my dog. It's Max the dog. And Max, I've had a humor writer write a monthly blog for Max for 10 years. And so now I'm putting the 52 best stories into a book. Max is going to have a book signing. he's got his own column in 55 and older communities.
Oh my gosh. What kind of dog is Max?
He's a schnauzer.
Okay.
He's a schnauzer. The reason I tell you that story is that's what I call a pocketbook.
This is incredible. I just basically read the whole book just now.
That's right.
Like literally.
That's right.
It is so smart.
That's right.
And super handy.
One topic, like 15 questions, really simple. You can take 5 of those, stick them in your purse or whatever.
Brilliant.
And hand them out. Yep.
Brilliant.
$3 books.
Stick it right in your purse.
Thank you, Nina. Thank
you
so much. This is amazing. We will definitely see you again.
All right.
And we'll see you again. We'll be right back.